Hello. Welcome to Lloyd's Candy Shop. How may I help you today? All right. So you're just looking around. All right. Well, as you can see, we have quite a variety of treats to satisfy your taste buds. For example, we have everything from candy corns to hard candies, soft candies, lollipops, marshmallow candies, specialty candies. Then we have our chocolates, we have our caramels, toffees, you name it, we have whatever your taste buds desire, then I'm sure we have it. So, is there anything in particular that you might be looking for? So you're not exactly sure. Well, do you mind if I show you a few of our products that we have? See if it's something that may satisfy your taste buds. Wonderful. Is there anything that you don't like? Like, some people don't like hard candies. Some people don't like chocolate. Some people are allergic to chocolate. So, I figured I'd just ask. That would be safe than sorry. Start off with a pixie stick. Have you ever had a pixie stick before? No. Well, what a pixie stick is it's mostly flavored sugar, but it's real delicious. It really hits that the sweet sensing taste buds on your tongue. It's real satisfying. Here, try one. Tell me what you think. Good. Wonderful. I'm very glad you liked it. Because, you know, it really satisfies the candy man to know sweets, the sours, the spices that we offer can help make your day a lot better. Let's see here. Something else. I think you might like these. These are called Vegemans. They're fruit flavored gummies. And I think that this one here in particular is lemon, I believe. Try it. And let me know. Yours is lemon. I thought so. Mine kind of smells like grapefruit. Very good. Something else, if you like lemon, we have, it's not exactly a hard candy. And take one. Very good, aren't they? Now, let's see. We also have in the lemon category. Lemon drops. No, they're not are just lemon flavored candies. They're naturally flavored from California lemons. They are fat free and gluten free. Three generations of candy makers, Clay's has gained a reputation for producing smooth, textured, deliciously flavored hard candies. When you purchase any Clay's product, you'll taste the difference. Have you ever tried sugar babies or sugar daddies? You haven't. All right. Well, let's try some. I think you like these. What these are. Very chewy. You can taste the caramel and a little touch of honey. Which is what gives it its sweetness. Sugar Babies was developed in, I think, around 1935 by the James O. Welch Company. Sugar Babies was actually named after a song, and the song was called, let me think if I can remember the song. It was let me be your sugar baby. Now, the company was actually purchased by Nabisco in 1963. Tootsie Roll, or Charms LLC, now owns sugar babies. But the recipe really hasn't changed. They're still delicious. I still have the same caramel and sweet honey taste. Very delicious. Wouldn't you agree? I thought you would. Sometimes the paper gets stuck on the back of the candy when you pull it off. I've had that problem before. But they still are good. The kids that come in, they always like me to pull out a big roll of this. And they line up, and I just give them a big roll, and they go to town. Something else you might like. I know. Let's try this. The Haribo. Actually gummies or soft chews. Would you like to try one? Wonderful. Open this up. Yes. This is also the same company that makes gummy bears. It's correct. Very delicious, is it? Not too soft, not too hard. I think you might really enjoy. That's this. This is a chocolate cup. But it also has a creamy marshmallow filling. Now, there's actually quite a story behind this. First created in 1931, I believe, when a candy maker added too much vanilla extract to the marshmallow recipe. And it never set correctly. It was supposed to be more firm, like a regular marshmallow, kind of like these marshmallow peanuts. But instead, thanks to adding extra vanilla extract, it came out creamy. So they kind of just went with it. And now we have the vanilla milk marshmallow cup. Would you like to try one? Looks like a regular cup. Has some marshmallow coming down. It goes well with it, doesn't it? I almost think that it goes better that if it was firm. It has a nice, rich, smooth, creamy texture. Did you enjoy? Wonderful. Yes, it was very delicious. There's something else. Something else that you might enjoy. Let's try. Some pop rocks. I've tried pop rocks before. It was a very interesting experience. You'll see what I mean. This flavor just so happens to be cherry. Now, what this is well, not actually rocks. It contains sugar, milk, corn syrup, artificial flavors, and processed with carbon dioxide. actually, as weird as it sounds. But that's what gives it its fizz or pop. Would you like to try some? It's already starting to pop. Sounds like soda. Pretty delicious too. You can really taste the cherry flavor. It has kind of it's not like a real cherry. But it's more of a so far. Can I interest you in a soda? Wonderful. These here are it's actually one of my favorites because I don't recommend this for little children, but after you're done drinking the juice, you can actually chew the wax as gum. So it's kind of a two-in-one deal. Let's open these up and have. almost tastes like the Satan juice that comes in the hug jugs. You ever have those? It's pretty good. If you're into some other hard candies, we have these, which are Reed's Butterscotch, as you'll see with an advertisement, shows all the different flavors Reed has to offer. I'm a huge fan of butterscotch candies, preferably Werther's original. They're very delicious. But, yeah, if that's something that you'd be interested in, we also carry charms, which we also have an advertisement here. It shows the two flavors that you get, orange and wild cherry. These are good with any meal. And a little bit about charms. Now, these were actually provided in military MREs at one point. Kind of like an energy supplement. You know, the sugars helps provide a little bit of a pick-me-up. So they actually included these in military MREs. Just a little interesting fact. So, if you'd be interested in these, we have these as well. Both of these are 26 cents for a piece. Do you like taffy candy? Because we have, and this one here, Abba Zabba. It's a chewy taffy with a peanut butter center. And this is made by Annabelle's. Now, the first Abba Zabba was manufactured in, I think, around 1922 by Colby and McDermott before Annabelle's actually took it over. But it's very delicious. I think the taffy and the peanut butter goes really well together as it mixes up as you chew. It kind of blends really well. So I think this is something that you would probably like. But it's up to you. And this here's 50 cents for the whole bar. Something else we have is a couple different caramel products. The first caramel product is one of my all-time favorites in the caramels line, and that's the Goat's as well together. The caramel and the cream. One would think that the cream would just disintegrate before you even get to chew. But that's not correct. As you're chewing, the caramel softens and mixes with the vanilla cream. It goes so well together. This caramel, it's not exactly that chewy. It's really soft. So it's not like, you know, where it almost glues your jaw together. This is quite a soft caramel. We also have the Charleston Chew Bar. Now, this is a flavored nougat covered in chocolate flavored coating. And nougat and chocolate, I think, goes really well together as well. It's just like chocolate and peanut butter. Just goes so great. This was actually created in 1925 by the Fox Cross Company, or Candy Company, actually. This was actually founded by a stage actor. Let me think who it was. Donnelly Cross and his friend Charlie Fox. Hence the name Fox Cross Candy Company. Now, this particular candy was actually named after the Charleston, which is a popular dance at the time. So, kind of an interesting background for a candy bar, being named after a dance. But hey, if it works. Now, one thing that this recommends, and a lot of people told me they really enjoy, is this bar frozen for some odd reason. I've never tried it, but everybody I talk to, they always say that they like it. They like it frozen. They like it plain as well, but they said it's very good frozen for some odd reason. Something that you might like. And we'll try it out. That would be this. This is a cherry mash. Now, there's some interesting things about the cherry mash. Actually formulated in 1918 by a man named Ernest Chase, hence the company name. And he was the son of a doctor, Dr. Washington Chase, if I believe is correct, who went into the candy business in Missouri, I think around 18-something, 18, was 1875 or 76. But originally, this candy consisted of a quarter pound of mound roasted peanuts blended with a chocolate coating over a smooth cherry fondant. Now, they originally called this Cherry Chase, and then they changed it to Cherry Chaser before becoming Cherry Mash. Now, there's a couple different things that you can do with this. You can either eat this just like this, or you can actually this in a blender and create a milkshake with it. Or you can melt two of these and create a cherry mash sundae. Oh, well, it has the recipes right on the back here. For the milkshake, it says put in blender one cherry mash cut into small pieces, 3/4 cup of cool milk, 2 scoops of vanilla ice cream, and chocolate syrup to taste. Blend and enjoy. That really sounds good. So does the sundae. And that says, melt 2 cherry mash bars with 2 tablespoons milk. While still warm, pour over vanilla ice cream. And it can serve 5 to 6 individuals. So, there's really a lot of different things that you can do with this little bound, actually. It's a little ball. Let's open it up and try this out. Smell this. Oh, you can smell the cherries. Go ahead and take a chunk. The cherry nougat. It's real rich. That's the first thing that you taste, isn't it? Yes, and then afterwards, the chocolate and the peanuts. It's very delicious. This would be good as a sundae or a milkshake. Something else that you might enjoy. Have you ever tried the bar nut bar? Well, it's a chocolate wafer very soft wafer bar. Has a bit of a crunch. Also has a bit of a smooth texture as well. I think you'd enjoy this. So, and that is if you're a fan of peanuts, which you seem to enjoy the cherry. Just an idea. Well, I hope you enjoyed everything that we taste tested today. Did any of these items that I either showed you or we tasted, did any of them Charleston shoe. Okay. Alright, well, I will gather these items up for you and I will meet you over at the register. Alright. See you there.